A Gantt chart is a horizontal bar chart that is widely used in project management applications. Although Excel itself doesn't support Gantt charts, creating a simple Gantt chart is fairly easy. You just have to get your data set up properly. Look at our data. It is a table which shows the making of a software application at various stages. It has the start date, its project begin, and the duration in days. Look at the first row, design software. It starts on September 20th and lasts 20 days. Because we want to calculate work days, not weekends, we use a useful function called work day. Double-click on cell D3. This function will calculate the end date of the specific project automatically. Finally, we want another column called days in total to calculate the total days. It is a simple subtraction between end and start date. Let's check it. To create a Gantt chart, we need three columns: the projects, the start date, and the days in total. Let's highlight them with Control help. Now, go to Insert tab and select from Bar Charts Stacked Bar. Not exactly what we need, but it's the closest to a Gantt chart. Okay, the first thing is to get rid of the blue bar. It's the start date. Double-click any of these and in the Fill and Line tab choose No Fill and No Border here. Close the dialog box. The second step is to adjust the dates. Double-click on them. You can see that Excel calculates dates in values. That's why you see these numbers. No problem. Simply type in the first box the start date. September 20, 2014, and in the maximum box type the final end date, January 23, 2015. Of course, Excel recalculate them in values, but we don't mind. The interval between dates is now 20. Let's change it to 30. It's the days of the month. Notice that the date shows first the day, then the month. If you live in US, you might want to change it. Go to Number and simply change the location. Also, it will be useful to decrease the gap between bars. Click on any bar and change the gap width to 0%. We don't want gap at all. Let's change also the color of the bars. Click on the bucket and change the color from there. Green is okay. Data labels will be a good idea. Go to Design tab, click Add Chart Elements button, and Center Data Label. We don't need the dialog box. Our Gantt chart is ready. A final note, if you want the first project to start on the upper left corner and go downward, double-click on vertical axis. The last tab called Axis Options has what we need. Find the box categories in reverse order and tick. Now we made a beautiful Gantt chart. Thanks for watching.